Spreadsheets are one of the more common software applications used in the workplace. A spreadsheet is a virtual worksheet where numbers are calculated based on other numbers in the worksheet. Spreadsheets are most useful for performing a what-if analysis where a few numbers are changed and those changes propagate to other numbers on the worksheet, updating the calculations automatically and allowing us to see the impact of our changes. In this video, we will be using Microsoft Excel 2007. However, the concepts and techniques are not exclusive to Microsoft Excel and may be applicable to other spreadsheet applications such as Google Docs and OpenOffice. In this video, we'll be looking at how you can use a spreadsheet to perform a what-if analysis on your GPA if you happen to use a 4.0 grade point average scale. If you do not use a 4.0 GPA scale, you could adapt this spreadsheet to your own grading system. During the video, we will introduce some terminology and techniques which may be new to you. Please feel free to pause the video at any time you like, or replay previous portions of the video. Opening the spreadsheet available on my website, I see that the spreadsheet consists of rows and columns. The rows are indicated by numbers on the left side of the screen, while the columns are indicated by letters on the top of the screen. The intersection of each row and column is called a cell. If I click on a cell, I can see that I have selected that cell, and a black border now exists around the cell. I can see that the current row and current column have been highlighted. If I look in the name box, I can see the cell address, which is the combination of the column letter and the row number. If I look at the bottom of the screen, I can see my current worksheet and any other worksheets that exist in this file as additional tabs. The file itself, which might contain multiple worksheets, is called a workbook. If I look in the formula bar, I see the contents of the cell. Formulas are spreadsheet calculations performed within a cell. For our purposes, we want to replace the red text within these cells with the appropriate formulas. The 4.0 scale GPA is computed by converting a letter grade to a number from 0 to 4. This number is the number of quality points that will be earned for each credit that the class is worth. An A is worth 4 quality points per credit, a B is worth 3 quality points, a C is worth 2 quality points, a D is worth 1 quality point, and a failing grade is worth 0 quality points per credit. In our current spreadsheet, these quality point values have been entered manually. In a later video, we will look at how we can have the quality point values appear automatically based on the letter grade. We want to calculate the quality points earned by multiplying the number of credits for the course by the quality point value for the grade. In order to enter our formula into Excel, we simply select our cell and begin typing. First, we will enter the equal sign. Anytime the equal sign is the first character in a cell, this means that the cell contains a formula or calculation. Cells that simply contain a number, text, or a date will not contain an equal sign as the first character. Once we've entered the equal sign, we can click on the cell reference for the number of credits. We then enter an asterisk to indicate that we want to perform multiplication and click on the cell for the quality point value. We press enter and the calculated value appears within our cell. If we reselect our cell, we can see our calculation formula in the formula bar. We can edit the cell by editing the formula in the formula bar. We can also edit the contents of the cell by double-clicking on the cell or pressing the F2 key. When we edit the cell this way, it shows the cell addresses with color coding that matches the borders of the highlighted cells. This way we can immediately see which cells are impacted by our formula based on the color coding. I can also create a formula by typing cell references rather than using the mouse. Or I can create the formula by using the arrow keys on my keyboard. I can add the equal sign, press the left arrow until I'm highlighting the cell containing the number of credits, add the asterisk, use the left arrow to select the quality point grade cell, and then finish the formula by pressing enter. Once I have created all the formulas for this column, I can create a calculation for the total of my quality points earned. Instead of using the asterisk for multiplication, I can use a plus sign for addition. Entering an equal sign to begin my formula, I can then click on each cell and add a plus sign between each cell address. If I double-click on the cell I was working on, I can see each of the cell references that I was working with. This is not really the best way we can perform this calculation. If I clicked on the wrong cell, I might have picked an adjacent cell, resulting in an incorrect calculation. Instead of selecting each cell I wish to add, I can click on the cell I would normally enter my formula in and use the Auto Sum button in the Home ribbon. When clicking on Auto Sum, Excel automatically creates a formula that will sum the values for this column. It does this by using a function. A function is an Excel command that performs a specific task in a formula. As this is a formula, we still have our leading equal sign. After the equal sign, we have the sum function keyword, which indicates that the selected numbers will be summed. After the keyword, we have a parenthesis, which indicates the information the function will be operating on, and inside the parenthesis, we have the cell addresses that will be summed. What you might notice about these cell addresses is that only the first cell and the last cell are actually referenced. The colon in between the two addresses indicates that this is a range of cells, and all cells between the first and last cell will be included. We can press Enter and see the resulting calculation. We will talk more about functions in a later video. Finally, we will calculate the GPA for this first semester by dividing the sum of quality points earned by the sum of the number of credits. We will type the equal sign to begin our formula, click on the sum of quality points earned, press the forward leading slash on the keyboard, which indicates division, and then click on the cell for the sum of the credits. Pressing Enter, we see our calculated GPA on the 4.0 scale for this first semester. When it comes to using Excel, and really computers in general, there is an overall philosophy that if you're taking a lot of effort to do something, you're probably not doing it in the most efficient way possible. Computers should be used to make our lives easier, not produce more work. So we will fill out the remaining two semesters with this philosophy in mind. Instead of recreating the same formula over and over again, we can use copy and paste. Notice that when we copy and paste a cell containing a formula, the cell addresses are automatically updated relative to the location we pasted our cell to. These are called relative cell references. In a later video, we will explore relative cell referencing and the counterpart method, absolute referencing, in more detail. We can also paste a cell into multiple cells at the same time by copying the cell and then selecting the multiple destination cells before pasting. We can do this with our other formulas as well, including the formulas that contain functions, and the references are automatically updated to reflect the new location of the formula. For our third semester, let's take a look at another technique for rapidly populating cells. I will copy and paste a single cell containing my formula to the new semester. However, this time, instead of pasting to multiple cells, we will paste to a single cell and then use the feature called the fill handle. As we move the mouse cursor around the selection, you may notice that the cursor changes. If the cursor is a white cross with black borders, this means that dragging the mouse will create a selection of multiple cells. If the cursor is a black solid cross with arrowheads on each end and overlaid with a white arrowhead cursor, this means that dragging the mouse will move the current cell. If the cursor is above the fill handle, the black square set in the lower right corner of the selection border, the cursor will turn into a black cross with no arrowheads. This means that dragging the mouse will replace the destination cells with a series of values depending on the current cell. The fill handle is a very convenient tool that looks at your current cell selection and tries to predict how you would like adjoining cells to appear. In the second worksheet in this file, we have a number of examples of how the fill handle might be used. The fill handle can create a series out of numbers, text, dates, and formulas. In some cases, we might want a series to skip numbers or behave differently, such as counting by fives. To achieve this effect, we just need to start with a selection showing an example of the difference we want to see between each item in the series. The fill handle isn't perfect, but it is a great time saver. Returning to our original worksheet, let's add our totals for total credits attempted, total quality points earned, and our current GPA for our three semesters of college. Once we have completed our worksheet, we can right-click on the tab for the worksheet and duplicate it by clicking on Move and Copy and checking the box for Create a Copy. We can then rename our copied worksheet using the original sheet to hold our current grades while we use the copy for our what-if scenarios. As we make the changes and values to our what-if worksheet, Excel automatically recalculates our worksheet, and we can see the impact that it has on our overall GPA but without impacting the data that exists on our original worksheet.